In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My beloved brothers and sisters, we celebrate today the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary. As we gaze on her loving beauty, we ask her that she may help us reject sin, live a life of goodness, and love all the days of our life. So as to be less unworthy to celebrate the mysteries of Christ's love, let us implore the forgiveness by which we are all redeemed and saved. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Excelsis Deo.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who by the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin prepared a worthy dwelling for your Son, grant, we pray, that as you preserved her from every stain by virtue of the death of your Son, which you foresaw, so through her intercession, we too may be cleansed and admitted to your presence. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Please be seated. A reading from the book of Genesis. After the man, Adam, had eaten of the tree, the Lord God called to the man and asked him, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, but I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid myself." Then he asked, "Who told you that you were naked? You have eaten then from the fruit from the tree of which I had forbidden you to eat." The man replied, "The woman whom you put here with me, she gave me the fruit from the tree, so I ate it. The Lord God then asked the woman, why did you do such a thing? The woman answered, the serpent tricked me into it, so I ate it. Then the Lord God said to the serpent, because you have done this, you shall be banned from all the animals and from all the wild creatures. On your belly shall you crawl, and dirt shall you eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will strike at your head, and you will strike at his heel. The man called his wife Eve, because she became the mother of all the living. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous deeds. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done wondrous deeds. His right hand has won victory for him, his holy arm.
Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous deeds.
The Lord has made his salvation known. In the sight of the nation, he has revealed his justice. He has remembered his kindness and his faithfulness toward the house of Israel.
Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous deeds.
All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Break into song, sing praise.
Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous deeds.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavens, as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world to be holy and without blemish before him. In love, he destined us for adoption to himself through Jesus Christ, in accord with the favor of his will, for the praise of the glory of his grace that he granted us in the Beloved. In him we were also chosen, destined in accord with the purpose of the one who accomplishes all things according to the intention of his will, so that we might exist for the praise of his glory. We who first hope in Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women.
Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of David his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month for her who was called barren, for nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. Happy Fiesta po sa inyo. Palakpakan po natin ang Panginoon. Akala ko po 10 lang ang magsisimba ngayon, no? At mapupuno nyo na po yung ating wooden pews. And we greet you from your home, a blessed fiesta as we celebrate today the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Meron po ba dito yung mga narito kahapong gabi? Meron po ba? Yan, may mga ilan-ilan po akong nakita na yan. No? So salamat po sa pakikiisa po ninyo sa ating prosesyon kagabi, at sana ay nakadasal po kayo. And for the rest of us here, we wish to welcome all of you and once more to greet you a happy fiesta of our cathedral, the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Let me begin our reflection this morning. Year 2011, when a known boy band, One Direction, produced this song entitled, "What Makes You Beautiful." I have no intention to sing it to you this morning. Umagang-umaga pa ho. No? Kung ako po ang 6 PM mass, pwede pa ho siguro. Isa siya pong kanta na tila nagpapalakas ng loob ng isang tao na totoo nga may kabutihan ka, maganda ka. The lyrics would even press on important reminders and even eye-openers about beauty. When one can light up the world, when one's smile, one's goodness, that makes him or makes her beautiful. I wish you to look up the to look at the baldachin of the Manila Cathedral. It says there some praises about the Virgin Mary, and I invite you, let us all together read the words, Tota pulcra es Maria et macula originalis non est in te. You are all beautiful, O Mary, and the stain of original sin is not in you. And maybe we will ask the Blessed Mother, Mama Mary, what made you beautiful? Or maybe up until now, kahit po siguro sa dekorasyon na mayroon tayo, we will be asking her, what makes you beautiful, Mama Mary? Bakit ang ganda mo? And the answer is not far from the statement, because the original sin is not in her. Whatever can make her ugly, whatever can make her dirty, filthy, and even lifeless, God freed Mary. Her beauty lies inside a clean and happy heart. Mary's beauty won't rest in cosmetics or any surgical operations or procedures that can add her beauty. Maganda si Maria dahil malinis ang kanyang puso at malinis ang kanyang buhay. Ikinaganda po ni Maria ang kanyang pagtugon niya sa Diyos. Ikinaganda ni Maria yung pagdalaw niya kay Elizabeth ng may malasakit. Ikinaganda ni Maria yung kanyang pag-iisip sa mga taong wala ng kasiyahan. If you will remember the story of the wedding at Cana, when she stood at the fruit of the cross of her son, that made her more beautiful. At the moment of her conception, Mary was freed from all that can make her ugly and lifeless. Sin, mistakes, troubles, and whatsoever. And that made her beautiful. At hindi lang po doon, yung naging buhay ni Maria, masasabi natin, mas kinaganda niya ang pagiging tapat sa Diyos, ang pagiging matulungin, ang pagiging concerned, at ang pagiging matapang sa gitna ng krus ng kanyang anak. Mga minamahal kong kapatid, ikinaganda ni Maria ang pagiging walang sala, ang pagiging tapat, ang pagiging matapang, ang pagiging mapagbigay. Siguro po kaya natin yung mga huli kong nasabi, but to be without sin is something that we cannot all embrace. Pero kaya po nating umiwas sa mali o sa anumang magpapapangit sa atin. Hindi po natin ikagagwapo o ikagaganda ang hayagang paninira sa harapan ng mga tao. Hindi po natin ikagaganda o ikagagwapo ang magnakaw ng hindi naman para sa atin. Hindi po natin ikagaganda o ikagagwapo ang pagiging madamot sa kung ano man ang meron tayo. Hindi po natin ikagaganda o ikagagwapo ang pag-cheat, ang pananakit ng damdamin, ang hindi mag-alay ng panahon o presensya sa mga tao sa paligid natin. Magawa natin ang mga bagay na ito, mababawasan ang kagandahan, kagwapuhan na mayroon tayo, papangit tayo. What made Mary beautiful? Because she was freed from what can make her ugly and lifeless. And it is a mother's desire that as she is beautiful, she wants you and me to be handsome and beautiful as well. Madami man pong pwedeng magsira o magpapangit sa ating puso, Mary will always be there to make us beautiful. Being sinless, being good, being a loving mother, those things made her beautiful. And we can do the same when we reject sin, when we live in goodness, when we love, that will always make us beautiful.
Please stand.
Let us profess our faith. I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in our Lord Jesus Christ,
the only begotten Son of God,
born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
In her Immaculate Conception, Mary is revealed as the second Eve. She is God's new beginning for our race. As we honor her today, let us join her in prayer to our Father and Creator. For every prayer we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may grow towards the perfection of Mary, our destiny and our hope, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That through prayer and penance, the world may enter an age of peace, which is the triumph of Mary's heart, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the pure of heart may promote decency and harmony throughout society, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Mary, who is full of grace, may help us on our pilgrimage, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may rejoice forever in the company of Mary and the saints, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray in silence for our own intentions as we lift up to the Lord all the intentions offered in this Mass, our prayers for one another, for our dearest community, the Manila Cathedral community, be it those joining us online, those who regularly visit us, our dear pilgrims and faithful who would come and recourse to the Blessed Mother, to this cathedral as their home, for our dear nation and for the whole world, that God may mercifully hear our prayers, touch our lives, and make our lives beautiful. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father and Creator, hear us as we pray with the Immaculate Ever Virgin Mary, chosen before the world was made to be the mother of Jesus, your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
Pray, dearly beloved, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Graciously accept the saving sacrifice which we offer, O Lord, on the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary, and grant that, as we profess her on account of your prevenient grace, to be untouched by any stain of sin, so through her intercession we may be delivered from all our faults, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you preserve the most blessed Virgin Mary from all stain of original sin, so that in her, endowed with the rich fullness of your grace, you might prepare a worthy mother for your Son, and signify the beginning of the Church, his beautiful bride, without spot or wrinkle. She, the most pure virgin, was to bring forth a son, the innocent lamb who would wipe away our offenses. You placed her above all others to be for your people an advocate of grace, and a model of holiness. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Santo.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and our Bishop Jose, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Sa pamamagitan ni Kristo, kasama niya at sa Kanya, ang lahat ng parangal at papuri ay sa iyo, Diyos Amang makapangyarihan, kasama ng Espiritu Santo, magpasawalang hanggan. Coming together as God's family with confidence, we call on our loving Father as Christ taught us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Malingin pinagbibay, ang pag-asa ng tuhayan ng buhay.
Please stand.
Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received, O Lord our God, heal in us the wounds of that fault from which, in a singular way, you preserve the Blessed Mary in her Immaculate Conception, through Christ our Lord. Please kneel. Act of consecration and entrustment to the Immaculate Conception. We have recourse to your protection, O Holy Mother of God, as we recite the words of this antiphon with which the Church of Christ has prayed for centuries. We find ourselves today before you, our Immaculate Mother. We who make up the body of Christ present in our land, recite the words of this act of consecration and entrustment, in which we gather first of all the hopes and anxieties of our Filipino people at this moment of our history. Mother of our people, we rejoice in the name of Pueblo Amante de Maria, a people who love Mary. Bayang sumisinta kay Maria. You know all our sufferings and our hopes. You who have a mother's awareness of all the struggles between good and evil, between light and darkness, which afflict the world today. Mother of our people, accept the cry which we, deeply moved by the Holy Spirit, address directly to your heart. Embrace with the love of the Mother and Handmaid of the Lord, our people and our land, which now we entrust and consecrate to you, for we are truly concerned for the earthly and eternal destiny of every individual among us and for all our people. We have recourse to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Despise not our petitions in our necessities. From hatred, violence, and conflicts which divide and destroy our people, deliver us. from sins against human life, from its very beginning, deliver us. From the demeaning of the dignity of the children of God, deliver us. From every kind of injustice in the life of society, deliver us. From readiness to trample on the commandments of God, deliver us. From the loss of awareness of good and evil, deliver us. From sins against the Holy Spirit, deliver us. Accept, O Immaculate Mother of Christ, this cry, laden with the hopes and burdens, the sufferings of each one of us and of all our people. Let there be revealed once more, in our own history as a people, the infinite power of the redemption, the power of merciful love. May it destroy the power of sin and evil among us. May it transform consciences. O Mary, Mother of Jesus and our Mother, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. Amen. Amen. Let us all stand and sing Dakilang Tanda. I impart the final blessing, we wish to once more extend our greetings to all of us, a blessed fiesta, our warm welcome to the pilgrims and to all the devotees of our Blessed Mother. Maligayang pagdating po at happy fiesta po sa ating lahat. Let us also welcome in our midst our dear guest this morning, our most reverend Guillermo Afable, our dear Bishop. Maraming salamat po, Bishop, sa pagdating. We still have two masses this afternoon, our Fiesta Mass at 12:10 to be presided by Father Reginald Malikdem, and another Mass at 6 in the evening to be presided by Monsignor Roli. After the Holy Mass, it is our tradition that we also share with you the beauty of the image of the Immaculate Conception. All of you will be given the privilege to come up the sanctuary and not only take pictures of the Blessed Mother, but also to address to her your needs, your hopes, your desires as we continue our pilgrimage in this life. No? Kaya po, just give us the time to at least fix the sanctuary for you to peacefully and orderly come up the sanctuary. Our line will start from your left, dito po, sa ating pong side ng Blessed Sacrament Chapel after the Holy Mass. And once more, please do not only take pictures of the Blessed Mother, but also as you bid her hello, as you greet her as well, a happy fiesta. We ask her to bless ourselves, our families, and our nation. Muli po, mula po sa amin po ni Monsignor Oli, isang maligayang kapistahan po sa inyo. Salamat po sa inyong pagdalo. Alam ko pong may mga nag-half day uli, may nag-leave, may mga mali-late at na-late na. Kaya salamat po sa pakikiisa niyo po sa ating pong kapistahan. Palakpakan po muli natin ang Panginoon. Happy Fiesta po! The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May God, who through the childbearing of the Blessed Virgin Mary, willed in His great kindness to redeem the human race, be pleased to enrich you with this blessing, now and forever.
Amen.
May you know always and everywhere the protection of her, through whom you have been found worthy to receive the Author of Life, forever and ever.
Amen.
May you, who have devoutly gathered on this day, carry away with you the gifts of spiritual joys and heavenly rewards, forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.